This already I have shown you. This is schistosoma and this is fluke and this is Stainless oleum. This is planaria. These are also the member of the turbellaria class. This is tapeworm, causes a disease teniasis, and it is having two hosts. Which are the two hosts are there? Human and the pig. Alright. And its body is divided into three parts. Upper part is known as calyx, then neck, and the next part is the strobili, which contains proglottids. Okay. So these are the segments which are known as proglottids. Now, already till here we have discussed the nervous system is ladder-like. And now move on to the next one, that is epidermis. Epidermis is cellular or syncytial. Okay, syncytial means so many nuclei are there. And whereas frequently ciliated as well. Okay, now muscular layer present between the body wall and the gut wall. This is also important characteristic feature of this phylum. So, see this diagram. Here you will see that the upper layer is the epidermis, which is having so many cilia on that. And there is another layer that is known as the muscular layer. So, upper layer contains circular muscles as well as the lower one contains longitudinal muscles. Now, inside there are some parenchyma muscles also. So, these parenchyma muscles are present in the parenchyma region where parenchyma tissues are there. So, all the blue color portion you are able to see in this diagram, that is the parenchyma. Okay, don't be confused with the parenchyma tissue which are found in the plants. They are different from these. So, muscles are there, right? Then, no locomotory appendages. For the locomotion, no such appendages are there in these animals. Organs are packed in a tissue called parenchyma, shown you already. Then, well-developed gonads. See, from here, the gonads formation is started. Well-developed gonads are found in this phylum. See here, these are the ovaries and blue. In the blue color, you will see they are all testes, and this is the penis. Okay, ovary, and this is oviduct, then testes and the penis, and this is the genital pore from where they eject their gametes. And in the previous lesson, I have discussed with you about the vitiligo gland. Okay, see here, these are the yolk glands present on the body. They are known as the vitiligo gland because the egg which is produced in these animals does not contain any yolk. So there are different cells which produce yolk. They are known as the vitiligo glands. All right. This is a planaria where you can see I spot easily in this, so they are able to detect light. All right. So here you will see I spot, and there is a formation of brain as well as in the head region, and a ladder like nervous system is present. Next point is they have well developed gonads, already showed you. Then pseudometamerism in Tania, you have seen that is not a true metamerism. And some members have the high regeneration capacity. For example, in planarians, you will see they have a high regeneration capacity. Their body can regenerate. Till now, around 12,700 species are known of this phylum Platyhelminthes. Now move on to the members. Class of this phylum. The classes are three: Turbellaria, Trematoda, and Cestoda. So Turbellaria are also commonly called planarians. Trematoda are commonly called flukes, and Cestoda commonly called tapeworm. So now focus on the general characteristic of these. In the Turbellaria, also known as planarians, they are mostly free living and freshwater organism. Body is dorsoventrally flattened. Dorso means upper surface, ventral means lower surface. So from the upper surface as well as from the ventral surface, these animals are flat. So hooks and sucker are usually absent in this class. Examples are planaria, bipalium, otoplana, notoplana. So these are some of the examples of the class Turbellaria, also called planarians. Next class is Trematoda, commonly called flukes. Okay. Now here you will find the animals are mostly parasitic. Body is already dorsoventrally flattened, leaf like. Hooks and suckers are present because they are parasitic. Some of the examples are Fasciola hepatica, also known as liver fluke. Okay, this I have discussed with you in the previous lesson. And the other example is the Diplozoon. So these are the example of the class Trematoda. The next class is the cestoda. This class is commonly called tapeworm. Here you will find all the animals, they are parasites, exclusively parasitic, right? Body is dorsoventrally flattened, it looks like a tape. Hooks and suckers are present. This is the important characteristic of this class, cestoda, because they are parasites. The digestive system is absent, no mouth, no gut, because they take the nutrition from the host body. They directly absorb the nutrition from the host body. So that's why digestive system is not there. Examples are Taenia. Okay. Now Taenia solium is known as pork tapeworm. Okay. Taenia solium is the pork tapeworm, whereas Taenia saginata is the beef tapeworm. Now Taenia solium is having two hosts, human and the pig. Alright. Whereas Taenia saginata is also having two hosts. They are human as well as the cattle and the buffaloes. Right? Cattle or buffalo or human. So human. So they are two hosts. And this tapeworm generally affect those people which eat beef. Okay, so those animals, because it is found in cattle and buffaloes, so that's why it generally infect those people which eat the beef. Alright. So Taenia solium is known as the pork tapeworm and Taenia saginata is known as the beef tapeworm. So these are the three important classes of the phylum Platyhelminthes. What are those? Turbularia, Cestoda and the Trematoda. Now these are the unique features at the end of the each phylum. I have discussed with you the unique feature of that particular phylum. So here you will find parenchyma cells filling the space, okay, and then flame cells are there for excretion, and then there is separate Veteline gland for the yolk production, because the ovary which produce egg do not generate a yolk.